We want to solve the given equation by writing it in quadratic form and then solve by factoring. For this equation, quadratic form would be u squared minus 3u minus 10 equals 0. So notice in quadratic form, if we square the variable factor of this term, it's equal to the variable factors of the first term. So applying this idea to the given equation, we want to see if we square y to the 1/6, we would actually get y to the 1/3. So let's try it. We're going to write y to the 1/6 squared minus 3 times y to the 1/6 minus 10. Notice in this form, we can see that u would be y to the 1/6. But let's check this first term. Here we have a power raised to a power, so we would multiply these exponents. 1/6 times 2 is 2/6, or 1/3. Therefore, this is in quadratic form, and we can now try to solve this by factoring. So if this does factor, this will factor into two binomial factors. But now instead of using u and u, or y and y, we're going to use y to the 1/6 and y to the 1/6. And now we want the factors of negative 10 that add to negative 3. That would be negative 5 and positive 2. And now this is equal to 0 when these factors are equal to 0. So we want to know when y to the 1/6 minus 5 is equal to 0, or when y to the 1/6 plus 2 is equal to 0. So here we'll add 5 to both sides. Y to the 1/6 equals 5. We want y to the first, not y to the 1/6. So if we raise this to the 6th power, we would have y to the first. So we must do the same to the right side. So now we'd have y equals 5 to the 6th is equal to 15,625. On the right side, we would subtract 2 on both sides. So we'd have y to the 1/6 equals negative 2. Raise both sides to the 6th power. And here we have y equals, this would be negative 2 to the 6th is going to be positive 64. Now it's important that we use this technique that we actually check our solutions back into the original equation. Sometimes we'll have extraneous solutions or solutions that don't work. So of course we must exclude those. So let's go ahead and check this with our calculator. So we'll have 15,625 raised to the 1/3 power. Minus 3 times 15,625 raised to the 1/6 power minus 10. So this solution checks, and now we'll check 64. So we'll have 64 to the 1/3 power minus 3 times 64 to the 1/6 minus 10. Notice how this is not equal to 0, and therefore 64 is not a solution. So we must exclude this as a solution, so we only have one solution to this equation. So this is why it's so important to check our solutions when using this technique. I do want to make a quick point on why there was no solution here. When we had the equation y to the 1/6 equals negative 2, in radical form, that would be the 6th root of y equals negative 2. Remember, when the index is even, this result would always be greater than 0. It cannot equal a negative value. So that's really the reason why there was no solution. Okay, we'll take a look at another example in the next video.